Let's discuss another concept of volume of solids of revolution. To understand what do we mean by solids of revolution, let's consider a curve of say a function given as y is equals to f of x. And we have drawn the curve from the limits of its x coordinate from x1 to x2. This would be the shape between x1 and x2, these two limits. Now, if the curve is rotated or revolved about the x-axis like this, you just consider that what we are having, we just keep this x-axis fixed and we rotate it or twist it by 360 degree. What will happen? This curve will rotate and finally come back to this original position. Now, in this situation, when the curve is rotated, you can imagine what type of solid it is going to frame. Finally, it is going to give us such a volume like this. When it is revolved, a solid will be created due to revolution of this particular curve. And say we are required to find the volume of this solid of revolution. That's quite easy to calculate. Like again, as we have studied to evaluate the volume of any given solid object, we need to consider an element, integrating which we can get the volume of the whole solid. Here we can see due to revolution, we are getting a round or an object which is having its round circumference or periphery at various point or various points on the surface of this particular solid. In this situation, to get its volume, what we'll do? From origin at a distance x, we consider an elemental disk which is of width dx. So, if you consider an elemental disk of width dx, it is like this. Such a small disk when integrated between x1 to x2, you can see we are going to get this complete solid. And the radius of this disk will certainly be given by the value of y coordinate at the position x. So, in this situation, if we talk about the volume of elemental disk, this can be simply given by pi y squared dx. So, volume of solid of revolution between x equals to x1 to x equals to x2 is, this can be written as integration of dv, which is integrated from pi. Y can be substituted as f of x whole square into dx, and it will be integrated within limits from x1 to x2. So, whatever function you are given with, you just substitute the value of function, and correspondingly on integrating, you will get the volume of solid of revolution.